Now the next one is, so we still don't know the formula. So nobody knows the formula yet. But I am still asking you to tell me why the following formulas are correct. Okay, we don't know what is P, we just know the meaning of PNR. Is that okay? We just know what is the meaning of PNR. We have defined. This is the number of ways to take our objects out of N and then make arrangement. The number of ways to do that. The number of permutations. And we want to show that this is all is going to be equal to PRR times CNR. So I want you to prove that without knowing the formula. So why is it true? Why is it true? Why is it true? Okay, so let's take a look of what is PNR. PNR is what? PNR is you have a collection of N items. You want to count the number of ways to doing what? To select R items outside, right? You take R items outside and arrange. Arrange. You make arrangement. Arrangement. Is that okay? So you, it's like you select R items outside and then you make arrangement, right? Okay. So the number of ways of PNR that we want to calculate is equal to the number of ways to select R items times the number of ways to arrange these R items. Does that make sense? Because we are using rule of product. In order to get PNR, we need to select and, this is the keyword, and arrange. We first select, and then we arrange, right? Okay, what is the number of ways to select R items? The number of ways to select R items is CNR. How about the number of ways to arrange? Arrange what? You have already selected R items, right? So after the first step, you have selected R items. You just have R items. And then you want to make arrangement. So what is it? So you are going to arrange R items out of R items. So this is this number. Is that okay? So this is it. So this is the reason why this is correct. Okay? Okay? Now, this is very, very good. It is like we are just using, it is just like we don't know any formulas. We don't know any mathematics, but we can still convince people that this is true. Wow, this is a very good feeling thing, right? So this is a kind of a proof that is very useful, especially when we are dealing with counting problems. This kind of proof that doesn't use equations, we are not using any equations, but we are using reasoning. We call them combinatorial arguments. So we call this combinatorial argument. We are not using any formulas, but we still can prove things to be correct. And then it is always good to have a combinatorial argument because it saves us time to verify the equations, whether you are doing some miscalculation or mistakes there. But still, it is a formal way of proving things. So later in the course, in some of the assignment problems, we will ask you to provide a proof in this form, a combinatorial argument, to show something is correct. In that case, don't write down the formula. If you write down the formula or whatever, then it is going to be 0 marks because you are not doing anything that we want you to do. And that it takes time, okay? On the other hand, if you know the logic, the reasoning, then it is going to be an easy task. Now, this is the first one. I have two more for you. Okay. The second one is The second one is we want to show this P N N is equal to P N R times P N minus R N minus R. Okay? So P N N is equal to P N R times, so this is times,P n minus r, P n minus r. So what is P n n? P n n is that I have n things. I want to make arrangement of them. P n r is I just focus on getting only r of them and make arrangement. And then P n minus r, P n minus r is I have n minus r things and want to make arrangement of the remaining items.So why is it correct? Does it look correct? Does it look correct? So there are n items, right? There are n items here. And then I want to make arrangement of them. So let's arrange all. Okay. So you can...So this is my explanation. You can have your own, but this is my explanation. Let's see if you agree. So let's assume to arrange all n items, a very hardworking people would do what?You take out all the items and then make arrangement. Is that okay? But if you are lazy, yeah, like me, I'm getting tired very easily. So I cannot make all the arrangement at the same time. So what I should do, in the end, I want to make all the people arranged. But if I'm not that hardworking, I'm lazy, then I may first get the first R items, or not the first, I may first get R items and arrange them.And then for whatever left, I leave it the second day to do so. So for a task of arranging n items, then I can divide it into two parts. The first part just focus on getting r items and make arrangement. The second part, I arrange the remaining things. In the end, I'm always doing the same thing as the other guy because I'm making all the n items arranged. Does that make sense? Does that make sense?Okay, so if these two things are doing the same thing, the number of ways of arranging n items must be the same as the number of ways to get r items first arranged, and then arrange the remaining items. So in that case, this is again the rule of product. So the other way is I selectR items and then arrange these R items and then finally I arrange the remaining what? So I selected R items to take away, so the remaining N minus R items. So the number of ways to arrange everything must be the same as the number of ways to do the selection of R items and then arrange these R items and then arrange the remaining N minus R items. And then these two together is P and R andThe last one here is P N minus R N minus R. Is that okay? So if I multiply them together, then we get this formula. Okay? So this is my understanding. You may not agree, okay, but let's say this is a challenge for you. If you don't believe me, then this is good, okay? Because I always hope that you can challenge me, okay? Yeah, I may not be, especially...Yeah, I'm making a lot of mistakes throughout the class. So if you don't believe, the first thing is go back, discuss with your classmates or go back home, think of a way that you can convince yourself. This turns out to be correct. You can later verify it by formula. This must be correct. But how do you explain it? So this is something that you need to go through yourself so that you can find a way that you can convince yourself. You tell yourself that why this is true. Okay. So this is tricky, but I hope you can get it. And one more. There's one more. One more that I want you to know. This is the famous Pascal triangle formula. So this is the CNR. I want you to show that CNR is equal to, for the first time, we are not using multiply, we are using plus. So it is CN minus 1 R plus CN minus 1 R minus 1 plus. Okay. So this is the number of ways to choose to select R things from N. And then suddenly, you write it down into two terms, plus. And then based on this one, we know what is C11, right? C11 is equal to 1. Okay, so let's say C11 is equal to 1. We also know C10. I have one thing, but I want to choose 0, so it is also 1. So I have a 1 here. Then I can know that C21, it turns out to be equal to these two together. So I get a 2 here. So there is a so-called famous Pascal triangle. This is like 1, 3, 3, 1, 1, 4, 6, 4, 1, right? I believe you have seen this already, right? This is, okay, in China, we call this Yanghui Sanjiaoxing. In Europe, we call this, or in English world, we call it the Pascal triangle. Actually, Yanghui lives much earlier than this Pascal, but somehow this is Pascal triangle. And then each term here, you add the two terms above. Each term here, so we get 1, 5, 10, 10, 5, 1, right? Okay, in general, this term is CNR, and then the other term here, this is about the rho n is equal to 4, this is about the rho n is equal to 5. So C50, C51, C52, C53, C54, C55, right? And then CNR is dependent on two terms in the above row, CN minus 1. One of them is here, one of them is there, okay? So here we want to show that CNR is equal to CN minus 1 R minus 1 plus CN minus 1 R. So why? Why is it correct? Has anyone recalled the proof? Okay, let me ask. If you have seen or if you have known a combinatorial argument for this one, could you please raise your hand? Good, excellent, good. Okay, so let me tell you. Yes, so you can have a lot of different way to choose this, but the story, so for combinatorial argument, we usually want to create a story, okay? A story of counting things in one way. So this corresponds to the left side. And for the same story, you have another way of counting. So this is something that corresponds to the right side. So sometimes a combinatorial argument, we also call them double counting. Because we have two different ways of counting the same thing. Okay, so let's say there are n items here. So let's say there are n items here. For some reason, let's focus on one item. Let's say this item is very special. You like it a lot. Let's say this is your dream partner. Okay. Okay, very beautiful or somehow very smart. Let's say this is something that you like most. Now we want to select, so what is the the target. The target is we want to select R items out of it. So the number of ways to do so is CNR. This is by definition. This is the meaning of CNR. Okay. But you can think of this as there. So another way is you can think of selecting R items in two different ways. One is I must select this item in one of these R items. And the other way is I will not select this item. Is that okay? So there are two different ways of selecting R items. One is we include this thing. And then the other one is we do not include, we exclude this special item. So we want to count the number of ways of including this. And we want to count the number of ways of excluding this. But overall, we must be selecting a total of R items. Is that okay? Now, if I get the number of ways of this one and the number of ways of this one, adding them up together must be equal to CNR, because this corresponds to all the possible ways of selecting R items. Is that okay? This is the rule of sum again. Okay? To select R items, either we include this in one of your R items, or we do not include this in one of your R items. So the number of ways here plus the number of ways here is your answer. So, okay, exclude is easy. How many ways of selecting R items, but I will never got this star? This is simple because we just kick this away at the beginning so that I just have N minus one R, N minus items left, but I'm going to select R of them. Is that okay? So the number of ways of doing this exclusion is C N minus one R. Is that okay? How about this one? This is a little bit trickier. So how many ways to include this star? How many ways? I have to include this, so this must be occupying one of them. So what do I need to do next? So I take this, but what I need to do next is I must get R minus one more items from the remaining N minus one items. Okay, so to get include, I must first select these items one way and then get R minus one items from the remaining N minus one. So it is C, N minus one, R minus one. Is that okay? Okay, once you make a story like this, then you will see that this must be equal to this one. The summation of these two terms must be equal to this one. Okay, and what's good thing is we have talked a lot of things here so far, but we never know the formula. Still no formula. Yeah, this is something good. Yes. Okay, now let's do the real thing. So this time, let's get the formula for PNR. Okay, the formula for PNR. The formula for PNR is equal to N times N minus 1 times N minus 2 times dot 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 dot. How many terms are there? We are going to multiply this with all together R terms. So the last term will be N minus R plus 1. Is that okay? So you can also write this. So this is also equivalent to, if we use the factorial notation, N factorial is N multiplied up to 1. But it is similar to N factorial. If you start from N going back to 1, this is N factorial. But we are missing the terms afterwards, right? So it is N factorial divided by N minus R factorial. Is that okay? Okay, so we want to show that this is true. Okay, how do we show? What is this? Multiply, right? Rule of product. Okay. The number of ways to take R items, make arrangement is what? I can take the first item, and then I take the second item, and then I take the third item, and so on and so forth. There are N ways to take the first item for my arrangement. And then after that, My task is to select the next item, so they are going to be n minus one ways. And after I take the first two items, there are always n minus two items left, and then I can select any one of them as my third item, so you multiply it with n minus two. So you repeat this process altogether r times, so that you are going to select exactly r items in the end. So this is n times n minus 1 times n minus 2, and so on, up to this term, the r term. That's it. So this is applying the rule of product again and again. Does that make sense? Okay. Okay. Now, at this moment, let me introduce a handy notation, okay? This roughly, so if n is very large, imagine if n is very large, r is very small, so this is roughly n to the power r. Because this looks like n, this looks like n, this looks like n, every term looks like n, when this n is super large. Okay? So in some textbook, actually in the concrete mathematics textbook, we are going to give this a special notation for this one. This is a term that starts with n. And then we are taking r terms, but each term is 1 minus from the from the term before it. So we call this n to the power r with a bar here. So this is called the n, the falling function, falling. So this is the falling function, or falling power. Falling power, maybe falling function or falling power. So this means that you have altogether r terms, you start with n, and then each term is like minus one of the previous term. N minus one, n minus two, n minus three, multiply together altogether r terms. Is that okay? Okay, so n to the power n falling is exactly equal to n factorial. Is that okay? And then we can talk about n to the power n plus 1 falling. What would that be? What do you think? What is it? You have n and then n minus 1 and then n minus 2, right? And then altogether there are n plus 1 terms. So what should it be? 0. Because you hit the 0. Is that okay? And then similarly, we can have rising function, n to the power r rising. Okay, so this is what? This is n times n plus 1 times n plus 2. All together, there are r terms. Okay? So here, you can call this as n to the power r falling. You can also talk, this is n minus r plus 1 to the power r rising. So you start from this term, you have all together r terms, and then each term is plus 1 of the previous term. Okay. But in any case, this is a short-term notation. You don't need to write down a lot of things. And this also reminds us that this is really similar, close to n to the power r. So this is something that becomes handy. Okay, now we have a formula for PNR, right? We have a formula for PNR. And so we know what is PNR and we know what is PRR. Because PRR, you just substitute N as R there, right? You get PRR. Okay? PNR is N to the power R falling. PRR is R to the power R falling. So it is R factorial. Is that okay? So we will have CNR automatically based on this one. So if you write down, PNR is N to the power R falling is equal to R to the power R falling times CNR. Then you divide this term on this side, you get CNR. Okay, and after, so in usual terms, then CNR is equal to what? So this is going to be a little bit messy, but let me use this. So CNR, after you do this canceling, you get the famous thing, n factorial divided by r factorial n minus r factorial. Is that okay? Is that okay? And then, yeah, suddenly we get everything. We start from scratch. We start from just two basic rule, rule of product and rule of sum. And then we are deriving all the formulas. And one more thing. Yeah, this one is interesting. You see R and N minus R, right? If you reverse, so if you switch them, so Cn now is equal to N factorial divided by N minus R factorial, R factorial. So this also means that this is equal to Cn N minus R. Is that okay? Does that make sense? Yeah. But of course, you can prove it by formula. But there is a better way. You can prove it by combinatorial argument. So why is Cn now is equal to Cn N minus R? Why is it? So why is the number of ways to choose R things is equal to the number of ways to choose N minus R thing? Why? Why are these two things, why are these two constant same number? It's like the number of ways to choose R things to keep is exactly equal to the number of ways to choose N minus R things to discard. So these two has to be the same. When you are keeping R things, it means at the same time you must be discarding N minus R things. So these two are choosing the same ways. Okay, so the number are the same. Okay? Hey, how much time do we have? Pardon?
3 minutes.
3 minutes? Just 3 minutes? Okay, too bad. I want to ask you an IQ question. Let me see. Okay, let me ask you the IQ question next week. Okay, so let's end the class early today and then have a happy mid-autumn festival. Okay, yeah, let's end the class today. Thanks. Okay.